Hi all, this is my video tour of my show Algaery, or Algaery, depending on how you pronounce algae. The thesis behind the show is the idea of using the forms found in seaweed cast upon the shore to divine the future. So, here we go. So here we are in the vault gallery, which is an actual literal vault. Just going to take a second to show you the map. So this first piece here, this sculpture, is called Lovers, and each one of these has a title as well. These are acrylic gel transfers. So they kind of feel like fruit roll-up. This one's called Emanate. This one's called Entranced. This one's called Experienced. And this one's called Exalted. So the whole sculpture is on two plinths, and the gel transfers are on a piece of arbutus driftwood that I found at my local beach. This is a two-dimensional piece that I've framed with more found driftwood. This is ink and pastel on paper. This is a sculptural piece called All Signs Point to Yes. The title's taken from one of the answers you would get out of a Magic 8 Ball. These are also acrylic gel transfers. So the images that they're made from are digital collages of photographs of seaweed and life drawing nudes that I've done. So this is a good example of how if you don't have light behind these gel transfers, they really are hard to discern what the imagery is. But I just love how they look like the way seaweed dries underfoot at the beach. This next piece is also a 2D work. I decided to frame it against tissue paper. It has some cutout components. So the center of it is cut out so you can see the tissue paper behind. And it changes depending on how the light hits it. I also used a found piece of driftwood as a framing component, which I wrapped in pearl beads. Give the illusion of salt. This is a skin, I'm calling it, that I made out of coffee filters and glue. It's primarily here as a light bounce, but it's free hanging, so as people walk through, it moves and it adjusts how the light that's on a plinth behind it hits the room, which I really like. I love the translucent effect you get with the coffee filters and the little subtle shine on this side. This next two-dimensional piece is a pretty large cyanotype that I made that I then bleached with sodium carbonate and then re-stained using green tea. And then this figure in the middle is Caran d'Ache pastel. This next piece is a textile floor sculpture. This piece is called Portal. And originally I wanted to use this fabric, I wanted to sew it, but I've actually had this fabric since childhood. And it's so fragile and so delicate that ultimately I decided that gravity was the best way to get the folds that I wanted rather than sewing and pin tacking. Somebody said that it reminded them of the inside of an oyster, which I think is a really beautiful way of looking at it. This next piece is the entire wall. So I'll go in on each component. The whole wall is called Better Not Tell You Now. And then I've paired found driftwood with soft sculpture and then drawn on the wall to tie everything together. So the drawing on the wall is just soft charcoal that I've then taken a wet brush to. I wasn't allowed to paint in this space because it doesn't have very good circulation of airflow. So I decided to just use charcoal as a temporary solution. And I ended up loving the way it looked. This is another light bounce that I created using glue and coffee filters and a little bit of pigment, loose pigment. And again, it's just the translucency of it that I love. When I look at this one, I think of fish eggs, so. This next wall piece is a set of four. So each piece has a two-dimensional paper component, which is suspended, and then in front of that, a piece of driftwood is suspended. So with these pieces, I really wanted to look at the relationship between the driftwood acting as sort of a sigil or a character from a character-based language like Chinese, and how when it's pushed against this background, it seems to be defined. Right, like a word is defined with a singular meaning, but because it's actually suspended, it can be transformed. And those things we think of as solid definitions can be changed. So once these pieces of driftwood are in relationship with these backdrops, I wanted to think about how our perspective of them changes. And I wanted to sort of realize how fluid those meanings really are. So that's it. That's Algaery, folks. Thanks for coming along.